may give unto you the spirit of wisdom and revelation in the knowledge of him, the eyes of your understanding being enlightened, that he may know what is the hope of his calling, and what the riches of the glory of his inheritance in the saints, and what is exceeding greatness of his power to usward who believe, according to the working of his mighty power, which he wrought in Christ when he raised him from the dead, and set him at his own right hand in the heavenly places. 21, far above all principality and power and might and dominion and every name that is named, not only in this world, but also in that which is to come. And have put all things under his feet, and gave him to be the head over all things to the church. Can you say church?
Church.
Uh-huh. Which is his body, the fullness of him that filleth all in all. Paul's prayer, before we go back to 2 Kings, was that we would get a spiritual enlightenment of who we really are in Christ Jesus. This is so important. He said that we need wisdom. That's practical on earth. He said we need revelation. That comes from the Holy Spirit. Wisdom comes from how we live out our life. Revelation comes from the Spirit of God and gives us understanding how to live out in a way of wisdom. He said, but your spiritual eye has to be open. He said that when you get your spiritual eye open, you will not look at things as big as what the world, come on, Sister Hale, come on in this service, come on in this. You will not look at things the way that the world looks at things, the way that the world thinks all things are so big, so bad, so terrible. But when you have a spiritual eye, you can see right through the natural to the supernatural of what's really going on. Hard in the church today.
Yeah.
Oh, thank you, Jesus. And brothers and sisters, we are looking at a whole lot of stuff that's going on in the world.
Yeah.
I mean, killing, just merciless. Things that you see in the news and that they broadcast, and the presidential things that's going on. We are looking at a whole lot of stuff. And if you view it naturally, you will say it's bleak. Nothing is good. What's worth going on? Where can we find hope? Things are happening left and right in Cleveland. They brought in freight cars of tanks, beige tanks with these white letters on them. UN. You would have never thought that that would be 45 miles away. The United Nations has tanks in Cleveland set up. United Nations. You would never think that we would see that on domestic soil. There is so much going on. FEMA camps being built to house people. Martial law take away your constitutional rights. You have no say-so. All this stuff is going on, brothers and sisters. And you would say, what is worth living for? Why should I hope and plan and look for the future? There's so much going on. Gun sales are going up because people are living in fear.
Yeah.
Police are afraid to police people because they're getting shot.
Amen.
People are afraid of police because people shoot, the police shoot them. All kind of stuff going on. You look at the political arena. They don't want Donald Trump and they don't trust Hillary Clinton. But we ain't got nobody else. So when you vote for the lesser of two. It's just bleak in the world. But oh, Jesus said, Jesus said,
thank you, Lord.
My church shall never be damaged because the gates of hell shall not prevail against it. Let not your heart be troubled. You believe in God and believe also in me. In my Father's house are many mansions. If it were not so, I wouldn't even until I come, open up your spiritual eyes.
Amen.
Brothers and sisters, let me say this. We can't pray away this evil. We can't pray away this evil. You don't now see armies putting on red coats and they go fight an army that got on blue coats. You don't see that no more. The evil that's being fought can be anybody. It don't make no difference. You don't know what's in the mind of someone that just wants to kill up a mass of people. He ain't gonna put on no uniform. You can't fight that. How do you fight against that? What you do is you get saved. You get right with God, and if God said you gotta go through it, he gonna take you through it. And if you die from a suicide bomber, you ain't dead, you going to heaven. So that's how you deal with that. That's how you deal with that. God said, speak some wisdom to my people this morning. And tell them to quit fretting over what they see on the local news. Quit fretting on what they see and hear on the nightly news. Quit fretting on CNN and Fox. Quit fretting over that stuff. You can't stop it. I'm in control. You control what you can control. Live it up to the expectation of what I put on you from the Bible so that you're ready at all times when I come.
Yes.
Oh, am I right about it?
Yeah.
Am I right about it?
Yeah.
None of us are exempt from the evil of the world. But we're not of that world. So he prayed, Lord, open up their spiritual eyes so they can see you. The Bible says that he is far above all principality, all power, might, and dominion, and every name that is any. I don't care whose name it is. Whether it's Trump, whether it's Clinton, whether it's Obama, it makes no difference. I know a name above every name. His name is Jesus.
Amen.
That's my king. That's my president. He's the governor of all nations. He's the one that I go to. He's the one that can tell you what to do. You wouldn't be there if he didn't let you get there. So really, you are not in control. But if we don't see that spiritually, we'll give the government too much control. We'll give them too much talent of our minds. We can have our minds on God and see what he's doing in the midst of a crooked and wavering generation.
Yeah.
Oh, God's still blessing him.
Yeah.
I know things are going wrong out there, but in here, God is still moving.
Yeah.
God is still blessing. Yeah. He's still working out. He's still healing, saving, and delivering. Somebody say amen.
Amen.
Yes, he is. Yes, he is.
Yeah.
Last week, I stood in this pulpit, and I told you my foot was hurt. But after I started giving God praise, I went home with no foot pain, went on my job at midnight, and had no foot pain, forgot about it. Oh, tell me God ain't still doing things.
Amen.
Tell me God still ain't doing things. That foot affliction came from what I was doing out there in the world on the job. But God healed me. I don't got to see the revelation of this thing. But God healed me in the midst of where I got my pain. And what used to walk on me out there, now I begin to walk on it with no pain.
Amen.
Brothers and sisters, open up your spiritual eye that you can see God in everything.
Amen.
Even this stuff that's going on, he already prophesied about it. There's some things we can't fast and pray away.
Amen.
We just gonna have to be strong enough, spiritual enough, to offer an answer to those that don't have no hope. And here's the other part of wisdom. You can see the church don't get caught up in that foolishness, because if you meet your opinion with somebody in the church who don't meet your opinion, you open the door for the devil to get in between two brothers and two sisters or a brother and a sister. It don't mean nothing. You can't stop it, but help one another live saved. Exhort one another daily. Talk about the goodness of God in the midst of a crooked situation. Can't change it. Hate to see it happen. We're going to pray for them and they get themselves together. Thank you, Jesus. Paul said, Jesus has all dominion. He has all power. Let's look at 2 Kings. Brothers and sisters, that I need to get off my stovepipe. Okay, see, what the world will do is they'll try to draw Christians into that and it's subliminal to get us to have different opinions, which we all got opinions. I mean, we're human. We all got thoughts. But why this is like that, why that's like that, and how I can get, we all got that. But see, the devil will want to bait us into it so we can start debating and getting separate instead of coming together in unity. And that's what we have to have our spiritual eyes open to. That's what we have our spiritual eyes open to. Now here in 2 Kings, in chapter 6, let's look at verse 14 through 17. 2 Kings, chapter 6, verse 14 through 17. Talking about Elijah the servant. He was a minister of Elijah. Elijah went off the scene, and Elijah picked up his spiritual mantle as a prophet for Israel. And here we have a situation where Elijah is faced with something, kind of like what we're faced with right now. Here in verse 14, therefore, send ye filled the horses and chariots and a great host. And it came by night and compassed the city about. And when the servant of the man of God was risen early and gone forth, behold, the host compassed the city both with horses and chariots. And his servant said unto him, alas, oh no, my master, how should we do? What should we do? Here's Elijah's answer. And he answered, fear not. Somebody say, fear not.
Fear not.
We ain't got to fear. God's with us. We ain't. Fear not, for they that be with us are more than they that be with them. That's something to thank God about. And Elijah prayed, just like Paul prayed, and said, Lord, I pray thee, open his eyes that he may see. And the Lord opened the eyes of the young man, and he saw. And behold, the mountain was full of horses and chariots of fire round about Elijah. Now, right here, the king of Syria had came against the king of Israel. He came to rob, steal, and take away all the riches that the children of God had. Just like the devil right now wants to steal from you all the riches that you have from God. Well, somebody said, Pastor, I don't have a big bank account. But you know what you have is so rich? Your salvation.
Amen.
That's what he wants. He don't want your money. He got that. He don't want your looks. The devil's beautiful. He don't want that. He wants your soul salvation.
Yes.
He wants to steal it. He know he just can't take it from him. He got to chip away at it. Just chip away at it. Just a little bit here, a little bit there. To bring us down. To weary us. And you know and I know when you get tired, you don't make the best decisions. So he wants to weary us and weigh us down. That's why God said, tell the church, open up your spiritual eyes so you can see what's really going on. And if we watch that news and hear what's going on out there, it will weary us, it will weigh us, it will hold us, it will grip us, it will take us and just weigh us down. Where we can barely lift up holy hands. Where we can barely find a hallelujah, thank you, Jesus. But oh no, he's a bondage breaker.
Yes.
Through wisdom and enlightenment of the spiritual eye. So here, every time, the king of Syria would have a meeting with his troops. And they'd get a plan to ambush the king. Because if you can take down the king, the followers will fall apart.
Amen.
The devil thought if he took down Jesus, that those that followed would fall apart. But the devil didn't look at the power of multiplication. When he took down Jesus, who really gave his own life, when Jesus rolled up, here come more and more and more and more and more that are saved and sanctified and filled with his Holy Spirit to the place where John said, I quit counting because I can't keep up with the number. It's a number that no man can name. Let that just be it. It became today. I got some joy down on the inside. Thank you, God, our God. He's a multiplier. So now, just as Jesus said that the Holy Ghost will show you things to come. Elijah didn't leave his house, but he heard everything that was going on in King of Assyria's plans to get the king of Israel. He didn't have to send no spy, didn't have to have no undercover technology. All he needed and all we need is the Holy Ghost to reveal to us what's really going on. So every time they set an ambush for the king of Israel, he'd get away. And the king of Syria said, now this didn't happen more than once. It happened more than twice. Who in this camp against me? Every time I have a meeting, I'm going to get him this time. We set an ambush. He's not there. Somebody got to be a traitor. Got to be a treason in the camp. God gave one of the enemies some revelation. King, there's a prophet over there named Elijah.
Yeah.
Every time you tell us to set an ambush, God tell him where it's going to be. King, even when you go to your bedchamber and we ain't around, everything you say, Elijah hear, because God tell him.
Yes.
Amen.
You say, well, we got the wrong one. We don't need to get Obama. We need to shut the preachers up. Oh, y'all don't hear me.
All right.
Y'all don't hear me.
All right.
We was after the natural king, the worldly king. We need to get that prophet of God and shut him down. If we can shut the mouth of the church, y'all don't hear what I'm saying. If we can shut the preacher up, we can show them get the world. But if they keep preaching, somebody gonna believe the word of God, get their eyes open, and see what we're trying to do.
Yes.
So they said, wait a minute. We got a better plan now.
Yeah.
We're going to leave the king of Israel alone.
Yeah.
We're going to go get that man of God and shut him up. But you know what? We're going to do it wise. We won't go in the daytime. Yeah. We'll wait for the moon to get up and the sun to fall down. That's just like the devil. He's trying to do things in the dark.
Yeah.
But Jesus said, I am the light of the world.
Yeah.
You can put that dark out there all you want, there's going to be some light shining. I said, I thank you, Jesus. Well, you can bring some dark mess, but I got light in my eyes. I can see through your darkness. Don't try to fool me, Satan. I know just what you're doing. I see you coming at me. Oh, thank you. I think y'all feel that. So we're going to sneak up on them at nighttime. Get your horses ready. Hook up the chariots. We're going to ease up on them at night. God said, go ahead. So they came and they were around the city. And it seemed like it was going to be doom and gloom. And the Bible said that Elijah's servant got a word.
Yes.
And he stepped out and he seen across the mountaintop.
Yeah.
All around the city was nothing but enemy chariots and horses.
Yeah.
And it seemed like we're going down. Everybody killed everybody. The people that are supposed to protect us, they are now walking in fear. Everybody's going against everybody. Nobody can agree on nothing. Democrat, hating Republican. Independent, never had a chance, won't have a chance. They never just split the vote. Trump is arrogant, Hillary gonna lie. We don't know what we're gonna do. Oh my God, it's terrible. And he said, I don't know what to do, Master. But don't you know what God done? Those that did not know what to do, this young man, he sent him to a prophet of God.
Yeah.
And that's what the people of the world need. They need to go to church and hear a prophet of God tell them exactly what's going on. Far off, like the Holy Ghost said I would do. So this young man said, this is too much for me to deal with. I'm going to ask somebody that's got some spiritual wisdom and some spiritual revelation that Paul prayed about. That should be you. That should be me. So he went in and said, Elijah, you don't know what's going on outside? He said, yeah, I know what's going on outside. I'm abreast of the current events. And brothers and sisters, even though we're children of God, not of the world, but in the world, that don't mean you bury your head in the sand for the things that's going on.
Amen.
You keep up with current events. Amen. That way you know how to pray. That way you know what's going on.
Right.
Did you know there was UN tanks in Cleveland? The current events. Now you know what's going on. That shouldn't be. Them tanks ain't there to defend us. Them tanks there to control us.
Yes.
You better open up your spiritual eye.
Yeah.
Come on, somebody in this church. You better open up your spiritual eye.
Yes.
What we need a tank for? What we need a tank for? Ain't no foreign tanks coming over here and get dropped off by parachute so them UN tanks can fight against tanks. Them tanks are designed to control us. To martial law. Better open up the spiritual eye so you can see what's going on. Do not bury your head in the sand, but do not be overcome by what the world is presenting. You keep your eyes on Jesus. Uh-huh. So Elijah said, son, I know what's going on. I know they came in the middle of the night. I know they got horses and chariots. He said, well, come here. Let me pray for you. He said, Lord, open up his eyes. And you can tell when somebody got their eyes open spiritually. They don't walk the same no more. They don't talk the same anymore. Things that used to bother them, that they keep coming to you about, saying, help me, pray for me, pray for me. They don't have to come with that no more. They come now with a praise report.
Yeah, amen.
And am I all right in this church so far?
Yeah.
Am I all right? Because God says, speak wisdom to my people. When your spiritual eyes get open, your conversation changes.
Yeah.
When your spiritual eyes get open, your peace level rises.
Yeah, yeah.
When your spiritual eyes are open, your confidence in God reaches a whole level of faith that you never knew that you had.
Amen.
Really, you'd be like, I don't care what's going on, because I got God.
Amen.
And I remember the scripture said, no weapon that's formed against me shall prosper. If I don't live on nothing but that, through the blood of Jesus Christ saving me, and living on no weapon, I got enough to fight this battle. I'm not hoping like last week. But Elijah prayed. Said, Lord, open his eyes. You going out with me, master? I'm all right. I ain't got to leave my chair. I'm comfortable. He said, you going outside. When a young man went outside, he seen things a little different. Hitched his pants. Drew his shoulders back and drew it out of his chair. He said, my God, I see these chariots of Syria. I see these horses and chariots of Syria, but I see something different that I didn't see the first time.
Yeah.
He said, I see new chariots, I see new horses, but those chariots and those new horses, they got fire burning all around them.
Yeah.
Oh yes they do. Oh yeah. They got a fire that's burning from heaven, a lasting fire. The Bible says, is a consuming fire. If there's some mess, God will get in there and burn that mess out. Oh, yeah, Syria has some horses and some chariots. They were the natural. But when you get a Holy Ghost awakening, you'll see the fire of the Holy Ghost burning in your life.
Yes,
amen. Oh, am I right about it?
Amen.
Am I right about it? Then the Bible says that Elijah finally got up, walked out, looked around, said, yeah, I see him. But then the young man said, hey, master, there's more of them that's with fire than those that don't have no fire.
Yeah.
So that lets me know that there's more saints in this world than what we really think.
Amen.
There's some fired up remnants in this world that we don't know about. There's some prayer warriors in this world that we never thought about. God got some Holy Ghost fire people in that Elijah stayed on the theme of eyes. E-Y-E-S. So he went out and he seen all them Syrian soldiers. He said, Lord, blind them. And every one of them soldiers lost their sight.
Amen.
It's a terrible thing to lose your sight.
Yes, it is.
Because you don't know where you're going.
Right.
You don't know where you came from. And you don't know how to get there. You need somebody to lead you.
Yes.
So Elijah said, come on, boy, I know where you want to go. It was all blind. And Elijah took him right to the king. That's what he want. There you go. And he said, Lord, open up their eyes. Open their eyes and see the king of Israel. Oh, my God. And the king of Israel said, well, Elijah, since you brought him, what you want me to do? You want me to kill him? Elijah said, don't kill him. Don't kill him. Because they were prisoners of war. You can bring them back, and you can feed them some bread and give them some water.
Yeah.
Or reminded of the scripture said, don't worry about your enemies.
Yeah.
Don't worry about your enemies. But with love and kindness, go ahead and pray for them.
Yeah.
Those that despitefully use you. And then you know what you do, you're going to heat coals of hot fire on their head.
Right.
So when they talk about you, pray for them.
Yeah.
When they laugh about you, pray for them.
Yeah.
When they reject you, pray for them.
Because
you heat coals of hot fire on their head. And maybe their head get hot enough, their heart get hot enough, they'll give it over to God. The Bible says, and I'm closing right here. In Psalm 25, the secret of the Lord is with them that fear him.
Yeah.
See, when you begin to fear God, that's the beginning of knowledge, and that's the beginning of wisdom.
Yeah.
See, when you start fearing God, now you need the secret of God. And he will show them his covenant. His covenant is, you have nothing to worry about. My wrath is not upon you. Then David said, my eyes are ever toward the Lord, for he shall pluck my feet out of the net. If we do get in trouble, God will get us out.
Yes.
Turn thee unto me, and have mercy upon me, for I am desolate and afflicted. Sometimes we do get in trouble, but we can pray, Lord, look at my situation.
Yes.
And help me out. The troubles of my heart are enlarged. Oh, bring thou me out of my distress.
Yeah.
Somebody might be in here in distress this morning, but David covered it in the Psalms. He said, look upon my affliction and my pain and forgive my sins.
Yeah.
I want to say this, brother and sister. You may be in here today, afflicted and in pain, but it could have something to do with sin.
Yeah.
David said, I'm not ruling that out. I could have sinned against you by not knowing what I'm doing. Lord, open up my eyes so I can see what's really going on. Psalm 34, the eyes of the Lord are upon the righteous, and his ears are open upon their cry. The face of the Lord is against them that do evil, to cut off the remembrance of them from the earth. The righteous cry, and the Lord hears.
Yes.
When you're right with God, he hears your prayer. And deliver them out of all their troubles. The Lord is nigh unto them that are of a broken heart, and save the sins as a contrite spirit. Many are the afflictions of the righteous, but the Lord delivered them out of them all. Israel was afflicted, but God kept his word and delivered them out of all their affliction. You may be afflicted this morning, suffering in pain or heartache, but God. Somebody say, but God.
But God.
He is faithful to deliver you out of all of that stuff. If your faith can receive what's being preached about this morning, you should leave better than you came.
Amen. Yes.
And then when you get to where you're going, you should be the same in the same situation.
Amen.
If you believe it and can receive it by faith.
Amen.
Last one. Psalm 121. I will lift up my eyes unto the hills, from whence cometh my help. My help cometh from the Lord, which made heaven and earth. He will not suffer thy foot to be moved. He that keepeth thee will not slumber. His eyes stay awake when our eyes are shut. His eyes are always watching. They're always beholding. Nothing can sneak up on us. Nothing can get by us. Because if we get the eyes of the Lord and get the spiritual enlightenment, brothers and sisters, we will be in peace in a time of trouble.
Amen.
And yes, the United States is in trouble. But the saints of God should be in peace. If you can receive it, say amen.
Amen.
Come sit down. Come on,
hallelujah.
Praise the Lord. Thank you, Jesus. That's what the Lord told me, and that's what I told you.
Thank you, Lord. Thank you. What a word of wisdom, revelation for us. Now, Lord, it's up to us to go out in that world, open our eyes, and see what God wants us to see.
Yes.
Amen.
Amen.
Lord John, Brother Amos, could you bring the offering, please? Sister Dow has gone to work, but they're working on the Community Fest at this moment. If you feel like you'd like to give to it, you can give to either Sister Reynolds or Sister Dow, or if you want to make a check out, give it to All Souls, Market Community Fest, or you can bring something in. Either one, whatever you want to do. Whatever God leads you to do. Remember what All Souls is about. We say, bring